Hello everybody, today I have a quick look at an interesting first novel. I'm talking about Child 44 by Tom Rob Smith, a book already translated in many languages. For example, here is the Dutch version where you can see a picture of the young author, Tom Rob Smith. It's rare that a first novel is so interesting and so impressive. Also, from the blurb here on the Dutch edition, I learned that Ridley Scott, the well-known director, is planning to adapt this into a movie. So, now, a book that is being adapted into a movie is not a guarantee that it's a good book. So, let's have a closer look why this is so interesting. I will from now on look mainly at the English one. So this is actually the story of a search towards a serial killer, which is a genre which I usually don't read because I think they tend to be pretty boring, these books. Now in this case, the interesting thing is that it takes place in Stalinist Russia. So with actually that the Russian system of the time, full of suspicion, is actually almost like a character in this novel. That makes it so interesting. I read that the author was inspired, and I'm not surprised by that, by a notorious case of a killer that in Russia, in the 1990s I believe it was, who was actually very difficult to catch because of the limited technical means and the limited communication, as these murders were taking place all over Russia. It was very difficult to at that time in Russia for to align the results, and so usually they were seen separately. What he does actually, he doesn't simply transplant that story to the 1950s. He gives some background to the killer, some background why he has become psychotic, which makes him more or less human, you could say. It's debatable, but that in some way you can get into his way of thinking. Now, especially interesting is how we mainly follow the police agent, who begins actually as somebody who totally believes in the system, in the communist system, but loses faith rapidly when you notice that there's nobody you can trust, not even your loved ones. And interesting in the book is here that at various places the narrative stops, and then in the middle you have one line that attracts attention. For example, I just browse, and what do I read here? If I can remember your name, I can denounce you. That is really the essence of Stalinist Russia, of the paranoia that was there. And that makes the book so interesting. It's not really the murder mystery. It is really the atmosphere of a suffocating state, stifling all creativity, all love. And that makes it so, that really makes the book strong. Because otherwise, towards the end, there is quite a surprise moment in the book, which I will not give away. That's fun. There are some, you could say, action scenes, which I can imagine when Ridley Scott read the book, he thinks, oh, this will look well on the screen. In the book, I think, yes, they are a bit standard stuff. But as a whole, I would say, the book really leaves a very strong impression because of that portrayal of Russia. More important than the plot itself. I will read just one small thing about Kuzmin. Is by the way the boss of Leo, who is the protagonist of the story. Kuzmin reminded Leo that sentimentally could blind the man to the truth. Those who appear the most trustworthy deserve the most suspicion. Leo recognized it as a play on Stalin's well-known aphorism, trust but check. Notice that the trust but check is here, is one of those lines which is separate to really make it more piercing even. Stalin's words had been interpreted as, check on those we trust. Again here in the middle. Since those who weren't trusted were scrutinized with the same vigor as those who were, it meant that there was at least a kind of equality. The duty of an investigator was to scratch away at innocence until guilt was uncovered. If no guilt was uncovered, then they hadn't scratched deep enough. So this really gives the perfect impression of this book. I really was deeply impressed by it, and actually it made me plan to read from Solzhenitsyn. The Gulag Archipel is a book that I'm also interested in reading to know in a bit more classical novel form. A bit more about that, because it is again at heart, this is a murder mystery, but it's very entertaining. But thanks to the portrayal of Russia, there is a lot more to it. So, an interesting book, recommended if you like thrillers, but you like also books which go away from the beaten track. Thank you for listening.